tells us.
One ringy dingy.
For the better part of the 20th century, the telephone was the quickest and easiest way to communicate with neighbors, friends, and family. But now, with a steady stream of digital devices, it appears we prefer typing over talking.
I just can't stand chit-chatting on the phone. I hate it.
It's easier to email your office coworker, yes, who's across the hall than...
Oh, across two desks away.
Increasingly, the phone call is being replaced by email, and even more so, texting.
When you're trying to connect with somebody, do you typically email them, text them, or actually call them?
Text them all the time.
No phone calls?
No, not anymore.
Our cell phones are turning us into writers.
It seems that actually writing is a much more natural way of communicating than we ever dreamed was possible, and the text is a way for that dream to come true.
Techs are making the dreams of cell phone companies come true, too. Over the last 4 years, the major phone carriers have seen huge jumps in the number of text messages sent. In all, Americans sent more than 2 trillion text messages in 2010. Texting has even become the method of choice for returning phone calls.
Hey, Elise, it's Taryn.
I wondered how my friends would respond to voicemail for me, so I called 7 of them to make lunch plans. I reached one.
Hey, Deb, what's going on?
And left messages for the rest.
How are you?
By the end of the day, I'd heard back from 6. 2 actually called me back. The other 4 wrote me back. But then again, maybe I'm lucky they even got my messages in the first place.
You have no new messages.
Because it turns out, voicemail is so passé.
When's the last time you checked your voicemail?
I tell them not to send me one. I leave it on my voicemail. Do not leave a voicemail.
Oh, that's what you said?
Yes, I won't check it.
Even in business, voicemail has become more nuisance than must-have. Early show producer Deb Huberman hasn't checked her office messages since November.
Your mailbox is full.
It's been 135 years since Alexander Graham Bell made the first ever phone call to his assistant, uttering the words, "Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you," and ushering in a revolution in the way people conducted their business, both private and professional. Now the invention millions have thought they could never live without appears to be on its way out.
In a sense, it's ironic because the telegraph, which is a form of texting, was killed by the telephone, and now texting is killing the phone call.
So we rang up Jessica Bennett, senior writer for Newsweek magazine, to talk about this big shift. Now, we called you, Jessica, and of course you didn't answer the phone. You
first
instead
emailed.
Sent us an instant message, which was a nice touch. Good morning, good to see you.
Good morning.
Why this big shift from phone calls to texting?
Well, of course, you know, the technology has made it easier, obviously. So everybody's using it, and why not? You know, it's fast, it's quick. And, you know, studies have even shown that we get an adrenaline boost every time we text an email. So it's this constant stimulation.
So it's actually better to get a text or an email? You said that there's this stimulus more so than when you get a phone
call?
There
is, you know, and it's constant all the time. Tweets, texts, emails, everything.
Well, with the younger generation, even emails are kind of going the way of snail mail. I mean, even that scene is a bit too slow and not as advanced,
yeah,
is
yeah,
it not?
You know, we're all texting in abbreviated speak.
What are the real advantages to this, though, to leaving the landlines and the telephone call behind?
Well, it does streamline some things, especially in the workplace. You know, you can send a lot of emails to a lot of people in a lot less time, and it avoids all of the awkward things that come with face-to-face interaction. No eye contact, no small talk. So it makes it easier, and in a way, it's fun.
But why is that so awkward, face-to-face contact?
Well, I guess we're losing the ability to do it.
But that's the real downside here, is that people are losing the ability to interact with other human beings as opposed to just some little handheld device.
And we're losing the ability to see nuance. You know, there's a lot you can get from tone, from face-to-face interaction that you can't get over a text message, you know, especially when it's all worded in crazy language.
Well, that's the thing that I get every once in a while. If I send an email, I'll use my dad as an example, I'll get this nasty email in return, and I was just kidding, just because there weren't smiley faces all over. But that is something that there's a real breakdown there, not only with kids and parents, but boyfriends, girlfriends, husbands, and wives, and there can be a lot lost in the translation.
Yeah, miscommunication, definitely.
So you really think this is the way to go?
Well,
you seem pretty sold on this,
both.
And I don't know if the people at home are.
A little bit of both. You know, yeah. The average teen sends 2,000 text messages a month and only makes something like 100 phone calls.
So are we saying that basically phones will be obsolete pretty soon, that landlines,
I mean,
will be a thing of the past, won't have them?
I've never had a landline.
Yeah. Never?
And I don't think I will.
Goodness gracious. All right, Jessica, thank you very much. A little
Thanks
bit of a sobering
me.
Thought.
Right.
I got to get with the times. Thank you, Jessica. We
thank
appreciate
you.
It.